Today, we've got another hot seat challenge where we're talking to some pretty legendary characters. In the world of eKids, there are very few characters more legendary than Sophie Taylor. Now, Sophie has helped us out on eKids a few times, but one of Sophie's first acting roles was actually as Lemon in the Sophie and Lemon skits. Let's take a look now.
Some days I'm a good friend, the best you've ever seen. Some days I wake up mean. Yes, some days I wake up mean.
All right, Sophie, welcome to the Hot Seat Challenge. Have you ever heard of this challenge before?
Not really. A little bit.
Okay.
A little bit, but familiar with Hot Seat, but not with the extra stuff.
Okay, well, this is a little twist on the Hot Seat Challenge where we're gonna ask you a series of questions.
Okay.
And with each question, you are going to enjoy a nice, spicy hot wing. With each question, they're gonna progressively get hotter and hotter and hotter until we reach like the maximum, like most hot chicken wing that we could find.
Dun, dun, dun.
Dun, dun, dun. Okay. If it gets too unbearable, we have some drink options for you. We've got milk to, you know, soothe the palate a little bit. We have some lemon water just in case you're not like a big milk fan, but if there's like no dairy, no lemon water, we've got almond milk for you, okay? Delicious. Me over here, well, don't worry about my wings.
Okay.
But are you ready for some questions?
I guess so. Let's just go ahead and start.
All right, here we go. So, tell me about your role as Lemon. How did you get that character role?
Okay. Let's tell the story really quick.
Okay.
So, Sophie and Lemon is one of our, I think it's one of the best eKids series I've ever done. Just saying. It's great. So, we have two characters, Sophie and Lemon. They go on this journey to discover the fruits of the spirit with the Lord and things like that. I've played this character, Lemon. She is more of the crazy type. She slips up, maybe does things wrong, sings about it, and not a good pitch, but it was great, and it was super fun, and it's on YouTube.
I love it. You know what else is fun? Is gonna be watching you eat one of these hot wings. So go ahead and pick up your first wing here.
This one?
And yeah, that one looks pretty good. And I'll enjoy some with you, how about that? And then we're gonna jump into another question here. That's pretty good.
That one's actually good.
That was pretty good. Do you identify with Lemon at all, like as your old character and who you are now? Do you guys like have some of the similar qualities?
Yes, I think
so. How so?
I think so. I think in more of like a quirky way, like facial expressions, yes. And I think that's like a huge thing, or like slipping up and then trying to fix it?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so would you say in Sophie and Lemon, were you acting or was it like, just like, you know, a character you were playing?
I think it was more like, Sophie was playing her character, you know? I was more just like naturally reacting to some of it.
Yeah.
And then having to sing the songs, but it was super cool, super fun.
Okay, if you could only eat one thing for the rest of your life, what would it be? These chicken wings?
No, it would not be these chicken wings.
All right, what would it be?
I would say cookie cake, because I love cookie cake.
Oh, I love cookie cake. Do you like chocolate and vanilla icing, or like one or the other?
I'm more of like a no icing person.
Okay.
Put a little twist on
just,
it. It's like a giant cookie.
So it's just a giant cookie.
Yes.
Okay, well, let's go ahead and pick up this next wing here, because we're gonna take these questions up a notch. I want you to tell me about a time when you found it difficult to tell somebody the truth.
That's actually really good.
You like that one?
Mm-hmm.
Like, scale of 1 to 10, how hot?
Maybe like a 4.
Okay, not bad.
It's not too bad.
Do you like spicy food?
I don't normally eat it, no.
Oh.
So this is like me experimenting too.
It's a challenge. Okay, back to the question. Tell me about a time when you found it difficult to tell somebody the truth. Essentially, when was a time that you lied?
Okay. Mom, if you're watching this.
Dun, dun, dun.
Just hear me out, okay? Okay, so one time, this is when I just got my driver's license.
Okay.
I was 16 years old.
Uh-oh.
I left my house key in the house. And so I had no way to get inside. No one was home. My neighbors weren't home. So here I am, locked outside the house. So I'm like, oh, window. So I go to get into the window.
Mm-hmm.
I use like a stool or a porch chair nearby to like get into the kitchen window. And I stepped on, we had a flower box right in front of like the window,
oh,
and it totally fell to the ground. And I got in though. I got in and I fixed the alarm and stuff, so it was great. But it totally like fell. It looked horrible. There was no way to fix it before she got home. And my mom was like, "What happened?" I was like, "I don't know. I had my key, got in the house." But eventually I told her the truth. And I said, "Yeah, I destroyed your flowers. I'm so sorry."
Why do you think it was so hard to tell her the truth?
Because I didn't want to get in trouble.
Exactly.
And I didn't want to face the consequences. Yes. But tell the truth or else the consequences might be worse.
That's some good news right there. That's some good news. All right, well, do you want to have another bite? I mean, that one looks pretty good. You said you enjoyed it.
Yeah, I like this one.
Okay. So while you do that, answer this for me. Would you rather have gummy worm fingers or colored pencil fingers? I mean, it could be...
Like,
would your fingers rather be gummy worms or like all your fingers be colored pencils?
Colored pencils.
Why?
Say that because first I can write.
That's so true.
If no one can I can write, I can draw. Maybe it'll be easier to pick stuff up. It's kind of like having long fingernails, maybe.
Oh, yeah. Okay, very cool. If you had to pick like one colored pencil to be your fingers, what color would it be?
Oh, pink for sure.
Nice,
pink's
I like
my favorite color. If pink is your favorite color too, then I'm pretty sure we're gonna be great friends.
All right, let's take it up a notch. Okay. Go to the next hottest wing. Okay. I can't promise you how hot these are getting because
these
mine
are
over
good.
Here, mine are fantastic.
These are actually really good. I would.
Careful with what you say because we have plenty
more.
Yeah,
I'm just.
All right, let's move on to the next one. And while you do that, when have you had to make a hard choice that people never knew about?
This is a good one.
Okay.
That's not a good one.
Too hot?
But no, yes.
Okay, so is it getting like a little?
It's okay. It's a little hot though.
So I'm starting to tingle just a little bit?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, what was the question?
Yes, the question. When have you had to make a hard choice that people never knew about?
People never knew about?
Mm-hmm.
So.
I guess they'll know about it after this, so.
Yeah. So when I was in high school.
Yep.
I did cheerleading as a sport. And I got hurt one time. And I had to make the decision if I wanted to continue or if I wanted to quit. And so none of my teammates knew I got hurt. No one knew really, just the doctor and my mom. And so I eventually quit and nobody knew why until I can swim.
Wow.
So.
Well, if any of your friends are watching from your cheerleading team, now they know.
The truth comes out.
Hopefully, you know, you've gotten better.
Yes.
Over time, that's great. Which legendary character would you rather have as a pet? Would you rather have a full-grown adult dragon as a pet or Bigfoot?
Oh, adult dragon.
Why?
Because.
You wouldn't want Bigfoot?
No, because I wouldn't know where to put it.
You
know what I mean?
Or him.
Him, she, it.
We don't know.
I don't know.
Bigfoot.
But if I have a dragon, and like, let's just say a burglar comes to my house, I can just be like, release the dragon. Oh. And then the dragon goes and just like.
I'm gonna just go ahead and say, if I am the burglar that breaks into your house and a dragon comes out and all it does is.
No.
Probably not gonna be
fire,
very scared.
Fear.
Oh, fear.
Destroy.
Fire. Got it. Yeah. Speaking of fire, let's take it up a notch. We've got another chicken wing here.
This one.
Yes, that one. It's like almost our last one, which.
I know.
Yes, get ready. All right.
I'm scared.
We're gonna go ahead and dive into this next question here. Our next challenge that I have, this is fun. This is really, really fun. Okay. Keep eating here because I'm gonna pull these out here. We're gonna play a little game called Explain That Gram.
Oh, no.
All right, I'm gonna show you a photo from your Instagram, and you're gonna tell us a story about what's kind of going on here, okay? This first one, it's nice. It's you and some friends. The caption here says, "Sophie, you're like our little sister," literally. All right, so tell us what's going on here. I mean, it's kind of interesting.
This is funny. They're both named Cam.
Oh, okay.
So that's the twist. And this is when I did the Elevation internship.
Amazing.
And we all got really close. Those are my best friends. We went to go take pictures one day, and they pointed out how short I was, and they are very tall. So, I'm like their little sister, but
literally. That's amazing.
Small.
How tall are you?
I think I'm like 5'1".
Okay.
Maybe.
Okay.
But they look giant in the photo, so.
That's amazing. All right, we've got another one here that you can explain for us. What exactly is going on here? Because I see some goats.
Okay.
And is this you?
That's not me. That is my sister-in-law. She is super fun. So her name is Elena, and that's my little brother. So one day we all decided to go to a pumpkin patch, and there were goats there. And we didn't know they were goats until we looked up and they were above our heads. So it was kind of a
like a surprise?
Yes, yeah. It was a funny surprise. And then she ended up wanting one, so.
Did she get one?
No.
Aw.
Mom said no.
So. Okay. That's interesting. That's very interesting. I can smell these chicken wings. I mean, they're like starting
to
burn.
This one smells hot.
I know.
Yeah, that one was kind of hot.
Yeah. I don't know how you're going to have this one.
I don't know either.
Like, God, scale of 1 to 10, help. Where was that one at?
This one? 8.5.
Really?
I thought it was kind of spicy for me.
Okay.
Disclaimer.
Do you like spicy food?
It's
you don't?
Okay.
So this is like, this is intense.
Yeah, it's not my first choice.
Okay.
But the mild ones were good.
Okay, one more question before we get to like the hottest of all hot wings. Would you rather be the star actress in a movie or be the one to help out behind the scenes, and why?
Good question.
I mean, you were the star of Sophie and Lemon,
yeah.
So you know what that's like. Mm-hmm. Would you trade that to like work behind the scenes, or are you like, no, give me the spotlight?
I would work behind the scenes.
That's so interesting. Tell us why.
I love being Lemon. It was so fun. But for me, I'm more of a work hard. I want to see other people like succeed while I'm assisting them.
Yeah.
I think that's a strong suit of mine. But for me, doing Sophie and Lemon, I was like,
like, it was a lot of pressure.
It was a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
So I would definitely go for behind the scenes and be able to watch the end product and celebrate it.
Amazing.
So, yeah.
Well, you did great like in front of everybody, but I also know that you would work really hard behind the scenes. All right, are you ready?
I don't know. I have to
you can do
prepare
it.
Myself.
Moment of silence. Do you need a drink or anything?
After.
Okay,
but
here we go.
We'll move this right here.
Let's do it. Here we go. We're going to... Ooh. How is it? Is it hot?
Yes. It is.
Your
so
like
hot.
Nose starts to run a little. There's some tears.
No tears. We do not cry.
No tears. Okay.
But that is really spicy.
As you let that spice kick in, Sophie, what are some ways that young kids can have integrity?
That's spicy. My eyes are watering. Do you see it?
I can see
My
it.
My eyes are watering. What was the question? That is so spicy.
Yeah, it's pretty,
you see that?
It's
look
pretty,
at it. It
it's
is
pretty hot.
On. It's
I don't know
red.
that was a big enough bite. Can you give us just one more? Really, you gotta get all the spice in there.
Oh my gosh.
I mean, if you guys could smell this right now, it is hot.
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure my lips are burning.
Okay, so we're talking about integrity. Yes?
Yes.
Okay, so what are some ways that young kids can have integrity?
Okay. My eyes are watering. They're
I can see.
Okay, this is a good one. Integrity is one of the things that my nose is running too, so.
That's what we have these here for.
Okay, so integrity is one of the things that Jesus is doing or has done such a great example of showing us. So integrity is basically doing the right thing when no one's watching.
Sure.
So maybe you're at home playing with your sibling.
Yep.
And you see that, you know, you're playing a game with them. Maybe it's a board game.
Yeah.
And you see a way to cheat and beat them. But the right thing to do would just be to play the game.
Yeah.
Don't cheat. Do things the right way. Because you know what the right thing to do is. But even if you don't tell anyone.
Right.
It's having integrity and doing the right thing, even when maybe you won't get celebrated all the time.
Yeah, for sure. It's having integrity. It is pretty spicy. I can still smell it. Would you say having integrity is hard or it's pretty easy to do?
It's hard.
Why do you think it's so hard to have integrity?
I think it's hard because my nose is running.
You think it's hard because your nose is running?
No. Oh. I think it's hard because since, you know, you have integrity is something that you do when no one's watching.
Yeah.
I think we want everyone to celebrate everything that we do. Gross. To celebrate everything we do, and you want people to see when you do a good job. But one thing that Jesus showed us is that sometimes, like you said, doing things behind the scenes, sometimes that is more important than being up on a stage, you know?
That's so great. I love it. All right, one last bite of the hot wing.
Oh my God.
Because I've got one final challenge.
Okay.
Here we go. Are you ready? You're going to need it for this one. It's going to really give you the kick that you need.
Another kick.
You got it, Sophie. You got it. All right, for your final challenge, I need you to say the alphabet backwards.
Aw, nuts.
All right, here we go.
Okay.
In 3, 2, 1, go.
Z.
Uh-huh. Oh, I thought this was gonna be a lot faster.
See, me too, but you know, it didn't work out that way. Let's see, right. Z-Y-X.
Uh-huh.
Is that right so far?
You're doing great.
Z-Y-X-W.
Yep.
Is that wrong?
No, you're doing great.
Okay. Z-Y-X-W. A, B, C, D, G, D, D.
That.
I don't know.
You don't know?
That is so spicy. My eyes are watering.
Amazing. Well, Sophie, thank you for joining us on the hot seat.
I am crying right now.
I'm
what
sorry.
Is
I'm
happening?
Sorry. We'll cut it here. Sophie, thank you for being in the hot seat. Thank you for showing us what it looks like to answer some pretty tough questions, but also be a good sport as
thank
you're
you.
Enduring these super hot wings.
When do you get to be in the hot seat?
You know, I enjoyed mine. Don't worry about me.
Okay.
Don't worry about me. All right, we'll see you soon, all right?
Bye, guys.